for today's video is another review, another foundation review, and this time it's the Estee Lauder. This is another foundation that is popular sa mga sa YouTube or sa beauty, mga beauty groups. And I've been hearing a lot of good feedbacks for this foundation, so I can't wait to start and review this. And this is also the Takal version of it, kasi ayoko gumastos ng 2,700 pesos for something that I have not tried yet. So, if you wanted to know what my thoughts are for this product, just stay tuned and keep watching. So, let's go ahead and start. So, this video would actually gonna be a multiple purpose video. It's getting ready with me. It will also serve as a holiday makeup tutorial. And also a review for the Estee Lauder foundation. It's the Takal version again of the Estee Lauder. And this is the shade Bone. And it's also for 3ml. And I believe this is for 350 pesos. Plus the shipping. Alright, so let's go ahead and start. Wala ba akong primer though? I haven't applied any primer. Hindi tayo magpa-primer so we can test this out. So, yun yung my sponge. Yun the drill. Let's apply. And on the other, on the side of my face first. I believe I'm done with my first layer. As you can see, I pull it closer. In fairness, sa coverage-wise, sobrang hindi mo na masyadong makikita yung mga blemish ko on my face. Aside from my veins over here, yan, nakikita nyo naman yan, and some of the pimple marks. Pero in fairness sa coverage ng foundation na ito, ha, first layer pa lang yung apply natin, and yet, halos natakpan na yung mga blemishes ko on my face. So, this is how, or this is the comparison. Pili ko tama lang yung shade na napili ko naman sa aking face. So, apply na natin. By the way, the consistency of the foundation is runny. I don't know, based on my experience, but if the foundation is runny, it doesn't sit easily and it's gonna make your application a little bit easier than when the product or the foundation has a thick consistency. So, hindi naman ako nahirapan mag-blend. Blendable naman ang ating foundation. And I think I'm done with the 2 pumps of it. And this is how my face looks like. Although, I haven't applied anything on my neck yet. And a little goes a long way with this product naman based on the application at ang ganda ng coverage na, as I mentioned earlier. So, very lightweight on my first application or first layer of application. Ayun, so as I mentioned earlier, less visible lang ako marks. Very impressive. This is the side, the other side. And nakakakimis siyang tignan in person. Just like the Marc Jacobs foundation. Let's go ahead and apply another layer. 1 pump only. Kasi kung magkakasya na ako. On this side first again. Smoother as compared to the first layer. And yung napansin lang ako sa kanya, guys, meron lang siyang downside. Kailangan pala dito, kahit na runny yung consistency, you have to apply it smoothly or paano ba? Kailangan i-apply mo siya ng tama yung pagkakablend mo on the first layer pa lang. Kasi may parts ng face ko dito na parang walang foundation. Tapos pagka nilagyan mo siya ulit ng second layer, magnapupunta siya sa ibang side. Imbes dun sa part na dapat pinag-concentrate mo ng foundation. Yun lang naman yung naging problema ko on the application. But other than that, it's still lightweight. And mabilis pa rin naman siyang i-blend. But yan, nakakapin na siya again. And takpan na ang aking veins over here. Medyo visible lang ng konti. But pretty much yung takpan naman na. And yung mga blemish ko around here are super less visible na. Unnoticeable na. Kapag tinitigan mo lang siyang itin. Yan. Ito kayo sure, yung mga parts we're in, parang hindi siya masyadong concentrate na ng foundation at yung dito part. For some reason, yun lang naman. Okay, so let's go ahead and apply it on the other side. Lalaban siya. Kailangan mabilis ka rin pala mag-blend dito sa foundation na ito. At kailangan i-blend mo siya mag-blend. Kasi mahirap mo talaga. So, mahirap mo mag-blend. This is yellow undertone. skin as well. So I decided to choose bone instead. Okay, second layer is applied. So this is how my face looks like right now. Yun lang, medyo may downside again. It looks like you really applied the foundation. I don't know if mawawala to kapag sinabi ko ng setting spray, but yan, parang medyo makapal siya sa face. Probably because of the coverage. Pretty much it's heavy coverage upon application in the first layer. Alam ko na na heavy coverage siya. Medyo heavy coverage. Ayan, kaya mukha siyang hindi natural sa face. Kaya medyo alam na nagpa-foundation pa. Although, upon applying the second layer, kahit heavy coverage siya, lightweight pa rin. Okay, applying my makeup. In the setting. Tira, ilagay mo natin sa atin eh. Ayoko na maglagay ng third layer. So, let's apply the concealer first. Ito yung pinaka-favorite kong concealer ngayon, guys. This is a LA Glow concealer. Super daming purpose nito. You can also use this as a foundation. I'll try to make a separate video for this using this as a foundation. Thumbs up, guys. Sobrang ganda nito. Nagbiblento sa kahit anong foundation na gamitin mo as a concealer. At I love this. By the way, this is in the shade Porcelain. Meron sila sa dollar store. Doon ako bumibili. I believe this is for 169 pesos sa Alimol. To be exact, doon siya binibili sa dollar store. So, if you wanted to try, doon siya mahanap. Super favorite ko. Never siyang mag-date kahit anong kapal lang nagay ko sa kanya. Sa aking face, never niya akong binigo. Vision decrease. Brightens your under eye area perfectly. And if you're looking for a highlighter concealer, this is perfect. Kasi may iba akong mga na-try na ginagawa ko siyang ginagamit ko siya as highlighter. Nagbubuo, nag-cake siya sa aking face, but this one, it never did. And this is also good as eyeshadow base. Sobrang galing ng concealer niya. Tinry ko muna to for a couple of days para masabi, para pag nagsalita ako sa inyo, pag nagbigay ako ng review, marami na akong masasabi. Kumbaga, subok ko na siya talaga. And napansin ko, simula nung unang tinry ko siya, may ganyan siya talaga problema. Ayan na. Ganyan yung ilong ko. I think na this concealer blends well with any foundation. Nahihirapan ako. So, isa-tun natin foundation and concealer with my all-time favorite Bronzer Baby Powder. For this makeup look, hindi ako oh my god, guys. Tanggal din siya dyan sa part na yun. Gagawin ko. I think this is a fail. Again, for the third use. Not sure what I'm doing. Medyo nag-disappoint na ako na kundi. And set natin ang ating yaning concealer, ang ating mata, ating eyelids, para magkaroon ng kakap dito ng eyeshadow. Set natin ang ating powder. And then, apply. Itong Kaplan Color Stand Rose siya. Nagagamit ko siya as a bronzer as well as extension na dapat nag-aayos shadow mo na kayo bago kayo mag-apply ng foundation para if ever may pull out na flat, mawash out siya using wash out talaga. Matatanggal siya using the powder na yun or that. Kaya lang kasi since this is a review, we have to put in foundation first. But yun, you have to, when you're applying your makeup, make sure that you go for the eye makeup first before you apply the rest of your makeup. So I'll be using my DYS, my favorite eyebrow gel.
So I just wanted to show you the looks that we create using those products that I've mentioned earlier. So maganda naman ang ating kinalabasan for me, para sa akin. And ganda ng pagkakatay ng ating eyeshadow. So this is perfect for holiday look. But I'm gonna create another, a separate one for those people naman na, alam mo yun, ibang look ng people. So just stay tuned on that. I'm gonna give you an update later kung nasa trabaho na ako. And bye for now. Alis na ako, guys. Sorry talaga, sobrang dami kong ticket. As in, 200 plus ticket yung tinapos ko. Hindi pa ako tapos, kaya hindi ako makapag-update. So, it's now 5:55 PM. That's more than 8 hours since I applied the makeup and hindi lang ako nag-retouch buong araw. This is how my face looks like. Ang ganda rin ng oil control nito, in fairness. At tingnan nyo, I'll call you closer. Nakikita nyo, T-zone area ko lang naman and yung inner cheeks ko lang yung blush on. Ayan pa yan ever since I applied my makeup earlier. And ayan, intact pa rin siya sa face ko. And ang ganda ng coverage nitong foundation na to, in all fairness sa kanya. And it's like the Remarkable foundation or the Marc Jacobs foundation when it comes to oil control and coverage. But I prefer this Estee Lauder when it comes to oil control kasi never akong nag-retouch dito. Really looks good kahit na oily. Kahit na medyo oily. At basta hindi talaga ako masyadong nag-oil up sa kanya. Kahit na bumiyahin na ako compared sa Marc Jacobs, mas maganda ang oil control factor nito. And ayun pala, medyo sticky na lang siya sa face upon application kasi of the foundation itself. Kaya siguro pag in-apply mo siya, pag binlikan mo siya, parang may mga side or may mga parts ng foundation na nawawala kasi sticky siya. Yun lang after you apply the foundation. But after you have set it with the powder, right now, since may oil na, wala namang sticky, irritating feeling akong nararamdaman. Still lightweight. I don't feel like I'm wearing a foundation, although since it's heavy coverage, as I mentioned, it really looks like you're wearing a foundation up front. You really have to set it with a setting spray. Yun lang naman ang downside niya. At saka yung nagra-rub off na siya sa kapag when you're applying the foundation or kapag binalikan mo siya. Nevertheless, it's also like the Marc Jacobs foundation. It did not rub off on my nose area, on my chin, and on my T-zone. So, halos pareha sila ng benefits or advantages. Sobrang ganda ng coverage, kaya mahal. And so far, yun pa naman yung napapansin ko. Let's see if this will be transfer-proof or not. Hold on. So, here's my tissue. Tingnan natin yung konting oil sa aking face. It's not transfer-proof, as you can see. Compared sa Marc Jacobs, mas marami siyang mag-transfer. Kasi sa Marc Jacobs, konting-konti lang talaga transfer. So, it's not minimal transfer, it's really a transfer. That's one of the bad side of this foundation. Pero, tignan nyo, after mo punasin yung face mo, tagalin yung oil, it looks good din. Although, hindi naman siya talaga mukhang masama kahit na may oil nasa face mo. So, that's gonna be my hot take. I'll give you one first update. I'll give you another update later pag nasa bahay na ako.
Alright. This will be my last and final update. So, as you notice, ayan, green na ulit ang aking background. That's because nito na nga ako sa bahay. And look at my foundation. Ang ganda pa rin ng foundation ko. Yes, it's oily. As you can see, pretty much it's really oily na. Pero yung foundation ay buong-buo pa rin. Walang nag-drop off sa aking nose. Sa T-zone, yeah, siguro may konti. And on my chin, wala din masyado. No, siguro konting-konti. But look at me. Look at how it was intact on my face. And yung blush on ko, ayan pa. Wala pa rin ako. Hindi pa rin ako nag-retouch. The whole day, pinabayaan ko lang. The last na pinapply natin yung tissue, chinek natin if there's any transfer, yun lang ang ginawa ko. Other than that, hindi na ako nag-retouch or anything. I did not apply anything on my face after that. And look at how fresh I am. I still am right now. So, it's really a very nice foundation. So, before I give you my last and final verdict on it, let's go ahead and proceed with our wipe challenge or our 24 or 12-hour challenge rather. Pretty much, ngayon pa lang sasabihin ko nung pasado siya sa ating 12 hours challenge. Kasi, hello, look at my face. Halos parang hindi naman nabawasan yung aking foundation. But, just to test it out, just para lang mag-make sure natin talaga nag-last long siya, still gagawin natin ang ating challenge. So, this is my wipes. Yung foundation lang muna yung tatanggalin ko alone.
Although, yes, it actually bends well on your, alam mo yun,
ang ganda ng pagkakayari ng foundation sa aking face. It's now 10:30, hindi mo ko na-30 na t-shirt, siguro mga 10:30 ako nag-start mag-last update. So that's how we were out. Nagpa-spend and half hours na natin siyang spot. And based on dun sa, alam mo yun, nakita natin yung base after 12 hours, I think mag-last lang ko siya for another 12 hours. If I would base on how intact the foundation is on my face a while ago. So yun na. But there's more. Siguro yun, performance-wise, when it comes to, as I mentioned, when it comes to oil control, longevity, and coverage-wise, it's much better sa particular foundation. But if I'm gonna go ahead and choose overall performance, I mean, from the time that I applied the product up to the time na nirimove ko siya sa face ko, I would go for the Marc Jacobs foundation. Why? Kasi this Estee Lauder has downsides. First and foremost, yung ease of application. So, parang nahihirapan ako sa kanya na apply. I tried it with a primer and without a primer. And yet, I get the same result upon application of the foundation. I don't know. Pero, every time na tatamaan, may mga parts din sa face ko na natatanggal yung foundation upon applying my second layer. Upon, alam mo yung madaanan siya ng sponge ko. I'm not sure if it's because it hasn't set yet or it have not set sa face ko before applying the second layer. That would be inconvenient. Set bago mag-apply ng second layer. Ease of application, definitely ang no. Munti ko na siyang sukuan kanina actually, sobra. Dahil ang pangit na flick na ito. Kinala na gawin ko siya ng paraan. Second one, it doesn't then well with concealer. Kasi alam niyo yung, di ba, yung concealer ko that works with all foundation that I've tried. Dito lang talaga sa SD ko, hindi gumana or maganda yung finish. I don't know why, what's wrong with the formula. But hindi siya nag-blend yun sa lahat ng concealer. Last, or pangatlo, it's not transfer-proof. Nakita niya naman yung result ng ating transfer challenge sa Wala Border. This is dun sa issue na transfer siya. It's not minimal. It did transfer a lot. Last but not the least, yung pinaka, siguro, yung last na disadvantage niya is yung price. If I would base kung worth it yung price sa performance niya when it comes to oil control, coverage, and longevity, yes, I would say 2,700 to 3,000 pesos is worth it. Worth it talaga siya kasi ang ganda eh. But overall coverage, overall performance, I would say no. Sobrang mahal eh. Sobrang mahal niya. And hindi naman siya ganun talaga. I mean, hindi siya ganun for a foundation na would cost that much. Dapat, di ba? Sobrang ganda na ng performance niya. From the start of application pa na. Up to pag tinagal mo na siya sa face ko. Which is what I had experience with Marc Jacobs. Isa lang naging problema. Dalawa lang naging problema sa kanya. Yung availability niya and yung kanyang price na sobrang mahal. Other than the performance, all over performance wise is good. Yun yung apat na disadvantage ng Estee Lauder for me ha. Sa aking skin type lang and based sa aking experience lang. But not saying that this actually, you would experience the same thing that I had. I'm not really sure why ang ganda ng mga review. Siguro based, binabasa nila yung ganda ng foundation niya doon sa finishing touch or doon sa final performance ng isang foundation. But for me, it didn't work fine. It's just that merong factors na ayaw sa kanya. Ayaw naman. But if you're looking for an alternative sa Marc Jacobs foundation dahil hindi na available dito sa Pilipinas at kung order ka naman online, eh, sobrang taas ng patong, you can go with Estee Lauder as an alternative kasi nga available siya, I believe, sa mga Rustan, small, and nakita ko rin siya sa Gateway Mall, so pretty much available siya dito sa Pilipinas. Alright, so yun lang naman guys, sana sobrang nakatulong nito. I enjoyed reviewing foundation so much, sana nakakatulong sa inyo, and if it did, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up dyan. Thank you so much for watching my videos, and if you like this, and if you wanted me to make other reviews, or if you want me to review a certain foundation, just let me know by commenting down below. And don't forget, of course, subscribe to my channel so you'll be notified. Lagi na yan kung may bago akong upload na video. Alright, so thank you so much for watching, guys. You have a great day and magpahinga na tayo. Kailangan ko kumain.